Hey, welcome to the show, and it is a Thursday evening, and if you just join us via, terrestrial, satellite, you're on social media, however you're joining, thanks for joining us, and thank you as we do the lockdown, continuing doing it, your nerd side. We've got a lot of stuff we're going to talk about on the show, and please be safe out there, and I hope you're practicing social distancing, okay? On the show today, we've got Anson Williams is going to be joining us, and if you don't know who he is, he played Potsie from Happy Days. Yeah, he played Happy Days. He's a director, actor, plus he's got some other stuff he wants to talk to. We'll get into that a little bit later. So one of the big things I want to hit is because a lot of people are on social media and they talk about it a lot, and I see it in all different venues from Star Wars and everything. JJ Abrams, we're going to get into what does he do better, Star Trek or Star Wars? And I have some backings for this, okay? So stick around for that. Also, we're talking about Marvel comic books. If you want to order them online, it is almost impossible to order them. Why? I've been talking to their customer service department, and I'll let you know why, okay? But DC's doing a good job on this. Thank God for DC! Oh, my God. They actually did something right. And then we're going to hit, I don't know, I don't have my notes in here. I just gave them all to you. Tron. Tron is coming back. All right, we're going to come right back. Stick around. We've got a lot to do on the show, so hold up.
Welcome to Comic-Con,
where once a year, sci-fi buffs take their lips off the barrel of a loaded gun and spend half a day adjusting their eyes to sunlight.
You want to see a comic book with pregnant zombie nuns?
You psychotic nerd!
Dude, what a bunch of freaking nerdos.
Good to see I'm white and nerdy. Good to be I'm white and nerdy.
I'm a nerd, too.
Your personality needs some work.
You're not part of the popular clique.
But I was kind of a lonely nerd in high school.
I started a quilt. I did yoga twice a week. I wore flip-flops in public.
I like to roll with the gangsters.
Well, welcome back, and let's start the show, and don't forget a little bit later on. Before we even say anything, if you want to win those cool shoes, and I've got a winner going to announce today. We got to pull it out. His name is, and I had it written down here, Justin Seaman. I love your name, dude. Justin Seaman, he is from San Jose. Your name was pulled out for the shoes, and if you want a pair of Rick and Morty shoes, simple and easy, go to our website, yournerdside.com, to enter or win a pair. That's simple enough, right?
What happens if that's not his legal name?
I don't know. With a name like Seaman, that guy's got to win anything he wants, or he's going to get somebody pregnant.
I think he's a villain.
All right. What I want to talk about is, and this has been trending on social media a lot lately, and hear me out for a second. We're going to talk about J.J. Abrams. Now, some people like him doing his Star Wars movies. Some people like doing his Star Trek movies. Now, hear me out before anything else. I actually believe he does Star Trek movies better than Star Wars. Some people are going to freak out and totally yell at me about this. Now, AMV, J.J. Abrams?
Star Trek.
You agree with me, Star Trek?
Shocking, isn't it?
Yeah, she agrees with me with something. This never, ever happens.
It's a miracle.
It's unbelievable. I can't believe it. You don't agree with me in anything. Okay, so first I want to go. He creates the stories, and he wrote the stories for Star Wars, and I'm talking about the newest episodes.
Yes.
And he did the stories for Star Trek, of course. I think, and I weigh out the two, and this is going to be me, and you can lay your own comments on social media or whatever you want. I believe Star Trek was a better story than Star Wars, and I'm a Star Wars. I like Star Trek, and I like Star Trek. I like Star Wars, and I like Star Trek. Star Wars a little more than Star Trek, but I like, William Shatner and all that. I just think Star Trek was a better storyline.
But you're not explaining why. Storyline?
Oh, the storyline.
Or he directed?
No, not the directing. I'm going strictly with storyline right now. The storyline that he wrote with everything for Star Trek, continuity, how he changed the past and he rebooted it and everything, I think he did an amazing job with the whole franchise. I thought it was horrible when he left and the other director took over and a new script because he had to go do Star Wars and the stuff. And Star Trek kind of went down the hill a little bit. I mean, what do you think?
No, I mean, that's evident about that. But what happened with the last Star Trek movie? Did he direct that one as well? Because that was not of the same essence as the first.
You're talking about the ship crashed on the planet and they had to get off, and the girl who looked like a zebra, the zebra color girl.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what I'm talking?
Don't sound like our president calling, that lady governor from Michigan. Don't be like that.
No. No, he didn't direct that. That was a different.
He didn't, right?
No, he did not.
Okay. Yeah.
He was like executive producer. That was about it. So he put his name on it.
So I think the thing is that he took a storyline, and this is what the director tried to do in one of the Star Wars movies that JJ didn't, and try to really reframe it. So meaning making new storylines. He gave it a twist, right? So everything has changed, but still keeping the essence of Star Trek. Now, with Star Wars, we can't blame J.J. Abrams for what happened to the second to the last episode. However, though, he's been always playing Band-Aid work.
Well, so, you mean you were talking with Star Wars?
Correct. So,
okay, let me ask you a question. Yeah. So let's go back to The Force Awakens. That is the. Do you think that was like an amazing Star Wars motion? Okay, this is what I'm going to do. Star Trek, that he did, J.J. Abrams. Mm-hmm. Star Wars, The Force Awakens. You put those two together, which ones are better?
Well, which Star Trek?
The Star Trek, the first one he did, the reboot.
Oh, you're talking about both of them.
Yeah, let's put them back. Those are both the first in the franchises.
I grew up watching CBS with Star Trek, with all the original cast, and love them. Not in love with Shatner as much as you are, but love the series. I'm like, let's see what they do, right? I felt it's going to be like Star Wars Episode 1, 2, and 3. But I didn't. I really was so impressed. Chris Pine moved me in ways that I can't describe here. So the casting, the directing, I mean, it was every little piece. It was just like a puzzle piece that
I know, but,
made
but,
a beautiful
okay,
picture.
Let's put them both together. But Star Wars, Star
Trek.
That's
what I'm saying. But Force Awakens didn't have that same puzzle. There was a couple of puzzle pieces that just didn't link. Like, think about how many questions. Well, how did that work? Well,
yeah,
what do you
exactly.
mean about that? Wait, that doesn't make sense.
The whole time travel thing when they went back and, the Romulans blew up Vulcan and everything changed. It rebooted the whole series. And I was like, okay, so this is the next thing. Yeah. And I wrote this down. That's on my list for you right there. The Star Trek cast is way better than the Star Wars cast.
Now, who would you replace from the Star Wars cast?
Oh, man. I don't know. It just... And I love the movies. It's sometimes they just didn't mesh well. It didn't feel like Ray didn't really with Poe. And I mean, they met. It seemed like they were all thrown together and they didn't fit right. Like all of a sudden when the movie ended and then, you know, Han Solo passed away. She just automatically hugs Ray.
You know, Ray and Poe never met each other.
No, I'm backing up. But when Princess Leia hugged Ray... And they never met each other, and she knew that. I understood they're trying to explain the Force did it.
The Force, is
yeah. It just didn't feel so. And if you go in the opposite way, Star Trek, then Spock and Kirk never got along, and eventually it's like, oh, these guys will never get along. But you can see how hate turns to love, and this great storyline. You know what I mean? I mean, that's what I like to say. And again. I'm going to get so much hate mail for this.
Well, I mean, the bottom line
I'm not
line
putting down The Force Awakens. I'm just saying that if I was going to compare Star Trek to Star Wars, and both franchises I love, in my room, I have a little more Star Wars. I got to admit that in the studio now.
I mean, he has two mannequins.
Yeah.
Then poor Spock is over there in the little doll.
There's nothing wrong with it, but I'm just saying. But like I said, next one, the casting. I mean, like, you couldn't ask for a better Dr. McCoy. You couldn't ask for a better Scotty. You couldn't ask for a better Captain Kirk. Yeah. Arrogant, into himself, women, shirt comes off. And
did it really?
No. I don't know. I really don't check out this stuff. I'm sure you would notice if Chris Pine's shirt came off for a second.
There was that 1 second. Yeah, there was 1 second.
No, he was in bed. He was making
That's what
out.
I said,
yeah,
for
yeah,
one
yeah,
second.
Yeah, they did that. And for playing Star Trek, you walk into I'm like, who the... There's no one that can replace Spock ever. Mm. But Zachary Quinto did an amazing job playing him.
Great.
Now, and we're not replacing Sulu. I forgot. Zoe Saldana for Uhura. And then what's his name? The late Anton Chekhov, who played Chekhov. Chekhov.
Yeah, unfortunately, who passed away.
John Cho, who played him. And I thought it was just well written. The cast, the crew. And then again, Abrams' Star Trek makes a better use of the franchise's past. That's another thing. So Star Wars tries to go to the past, and they kill off Han Solo. They go to the past. They try to rebuild another Death Star, but it's called Starkiller. We go in the past. It's just they talk about how, I was going to say William Shatner, but Captain Kirk's dad, he never got to meet his dad because he was dead, and it was Thor. And that's the next movie that
Chris Hemsworth.
Yeah. And J.J. Abrams wanted to bring him back. That was supposed to be the fourth Star Trek. And J.J. Abrams goes, this is going to save everything. If the you didn't like, and it was going to go do time travel again. He was going to meet his dad, and they're going to work on something together. Now you put Thor and you put Chris Pine together.
Oh, that's juicy.
That's just a great movie. You know it's going to be really, really good.
I just wonder what they say on the set, Chris. Hey.
Well, you saw that in Star. What is it?
The Saturday
three,
Night
the
Live.
The three Chris's. Well, you got Chris Pine, Chris Hemsworth,
and Chris Pratt.
Chris Pratt. What the hell's going on with the Chris's?
Something
man.
Good.
No, oh,
something
God.
Good. So, but, you know, the interesting thing, though, is on IMDb, I'm just figuring on IMDb.com, I was checking to see the rating scores and just curious what was the comparison. So, Star Trek has, the one 2009, has a
7.9. 7.9, okay.
Okay, guess what do you think Star Wars The Force Awakens
they have
received?
A 8.9.
7.9.
Oh, my God, they're the same? Yeah. Oh, my God, dude. That's weird.
That is very
okay,
weird.
Okay, so again, as I'm saying, because I'm going to get emails, and you're going to go to your nerd side right now.
Why don't you make a contest among them? Like, have them both watch one, and whoever gives you the best
this
critique.
This is all I need to know. Please tell me.
That you're right.
Which one is better, J.J. Abrams Star Trek movies or J.J. Abrams Star Wars movies? And I would say out of the two franchises, again, I'm voting, Star Trek was a better produced, entertaining storyline. After I got out of one, I was like, wow, Captain Kirk is back, so is Spock. And it seemed like they were going to be friends, and the way he's played off his Vulcan, like, it's just
you could tell how much he's in love with this, because obviously he has never talked about one topic for so long.
Yeah, it's just a big thing. No, I was really thinking about this, though. I mean, which franchise is better? And this is a big thing. And I'm talking about, all the nerds, and I consider myself a nerd in this kind of field of Star Wars and Star Trek.
Yeah, but there's not the sad part is it's kind of like the person like won the popular contest, which is Star Wars, and that's why Star Trek won't have another episode. Not anytime soon.
Okay, I wasn't, and I'm jumping topics right now. Oh, and make sure to follow us on social media if you get a chance. And everybody joining us on social media right now, we're Instagram Live. We're also, if you're on Instagram, you can see both cameras in the studio. If you're on Facebook,
you won't lower it, so it's on.
If you're on Facebook, you're just seeing straight to me, and it's just me in the studio and stuff like that.
This is more important.
So you want to push the logo? It's all about the freaking logo.
All about, okay, why don't you just go like that? Right.
That's all you do. You just want to see the top of her head. It's already.
So anyway, I'm surprised you're not ever going to talk about Star Trek Picard, Star Trek Discovery.
I can't get into Picard because I have not watched it yet.
I have.
I know you have, but can we wait till I watch it? And I'm probably there's a lot
you're
of people.
You're not going to watch it.
It's on Plex, and I'm going to watch it. And I'm going to watch. Look, I'm writing a note now on my paperwork. Like, watch Picard.
Okay, it gets slow, but it gets much better later on.
There we go. So last week on the show, we talked about Disney, and I didn't want to do it again because I'm like, oh, man, you know, I'm feeling sorry for Disney.
You're feeling sorry for
but
the
But now
villain.
I'm feeling bad for us. So, and you can go to yournerdside.com. Really? There's an article written about it. Okay. I was going to get into something else. And what's on the list? What was next? I forgot. She took mine.
No. He doesn't know how to use a copy machine.
I was.
Where is producer Brandon when you need him? Producer Brandon. Here you go.
Producer Brandon can't seem here.
He can't even write.
Producer Brandon has a haircut in like a month. That guy's hair. He looks like Medusa with that hair. It's pretty bad. So these are show. When you don't have a producer, this is show notes. This is what you freaking get. So. Marvel Comics, order that. Oh, I'll get into Marvel Comics later on because they really...